Have you ever wondered why silk is stronger? Because it is made up of a type of secondary structure, that is beta sheet or beta pleated sheet. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study secondary structure, that is beta pleated sheet. As we know, the protein structural organization, primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure and quaternary structure, and today we are going to study at another secondary structure, that is beta sheet or also known as beta pleated sheet. So this beta pleated sheet is the second most common conformation after alpha helix. Pauling and Curie, they discovered alpha helix first and later on they discovered this beta sheet, hence they gave name beta sheet. And most common conformation is alpha helix. After that we can see here and there beta pleated sheet. And this is a extended conformation and it is in a zigzag manner, so that is why they gave name pleated sheet or beta pleated sheet. As that of alpha helix, the main bond responsible for beta sheet is also hydrogen bonds, non-covalent bond, but collectively it makes a stronger bond. There are two types of beta pleated sheet. One is parallel beta sheet, another one is antiparallel beta sheet. So today we are going to study both this parallel and antiparallel beta sheet. First, let me explain parallel beta sheet. You can see the both strands, we call beta strands, they run parallel to each other. So here I have a strand where you can see this is one amino acid, another amino acid, another, and so forth. And this polypeptide chain can be made up of many amino acids. And this strand runs in this direction, from this to this direction. And another segment of same polypeptide chain, for example, this polypeptide chain can be folded with a different secondary structure or simply a turn or a bend, and it can join here. Instead of NH3, there could be a peptide bond here. So the bottom strand is most of the time another segment of the same polypeptide chain, because we know that the native protein is in a folded conformation, three-dimensional folding, that we'll discuss in tertiary structure. So this pleated sheet consists of two segments which runs in same direction. You can see amino terminal end and carboxy terminal end, N terminal end and C terminal end. Both the strands run in same direction. And these are all peptide bonds. Now this parallel beta sheet stabilized by hydrogen bonds. And this hydrogen bonds, as we studied in alpha helix, these two parallel segments of polypeptide chain are connected by hydrogen bonds. And this hydrogen bond between oxygen and hydrogen of different peptide bond. And we can see there are many hydrogen bonds, even though they are non-covalent bonds, collectively they make this sheet stronger peptides, makes a stronger protein. And please remember, in parallel beta sheet, the hydrogen bonds are not perpendicular to one another. And remember, this is alpha carbon atom to which always there will be R group or side chains, and this there will be hydrogen also attached to this alpha carbon. I have not shown in other amino acids. So this is amino group, this is alpha carbon atom to which side chain and hydrogens are attached, and another side there is carboxyl or carbonyl group which involves in formation of peptide bond with other amino acids. You can see the R groups are opposite to each other in two different segments. Coming to antiparallel beta pleated sheet, here one strand runs in this direction. So this is N terminal and this is C terminal end, and same polypeptide chain can be folded with the help of beta turn or loop, and again this segment runs from this direction to this direction. So here we have N terminal end and here we have C terminal end. Now both the segments are antiparallel. So here in this case the hydrogen bond are perpendicular. You can see again the formation of hydrogen bond is same whether it is alpha helix or beta pleated sheet with hydrogen and oxygen of different peptide bonds. The only difference between parallel and antiparallel beta sheet, the hydrogen bonds are perpendicular, you can see here in case of antiparallel beta pleated sheet, and the both the segments are in opposite direction. And this beta pleated sheet we call extended because the distance between each amino acid is about 3.5 angstrom when compared to alpha helix where the distance between each amino acid is about 1.5 angstrom. So beta pleated sheet is zigzag manner, extended and very strong because of many hydrogen bonds. So this beta pleated sheet is seen in both fibrous proteins and globular proteins. So the very good example is silk protein, it is called fibrion, where we can see many beta sheet. That is why silk is very strong. And in case of human beings, we have some enzymes where we can see majority of beta sheet, like carbonic anhydrase, a very useful enzyme for acid-base balance, and a protein which carries thyroxine in the blood is called transthyretin, which also has got many beta sheet. And this beta sheet has got a clinical application where some disease or disorders, we can see accumulation of misfolded proteins, and this misfolded proteins comprising of beta sheet. Because of this beta sheet, they are insoluble, they accumulated, and we see this condition as amyloidosis. For example, we can see in Alzheimer's disease and in many cancer and many chronic inflammatory disease where there is abnormal accumulation of misfolded proteins, they called amyloidosis. Because of this beta sheet, they are not soluble easily. So this is about beta sheet. Remember, whether it is parallel or antiparallel, the two segments can be connected by turn or loop or maybe some other secondary structure. Thanks for watching.